Scuba Scoop is sponsored by
Get Nana Habo Mouthwash and your problems will be no more.
Because not forgetting our proud sponsor. Yes, this episode was proudly brought to you by none other than Nana Habo Mouthwash. Get the product, try the product. For all of you who wanted the contact, it's right here on the screen. Give them a call, holla, let them know what you need. Let's delve into today's gossip though. Okay, let's first head down to Tanzania where I had a rumor. I don't know, it's not yet confirmed. I'm trying to look for the actual footage because, well, I kind of slept on the job. I say today is a really nonchalant day. I kind of slept on the job and didn't get the deets immediately, so I have not yet confirmed if it is true or not. But I heard that between Hamisa and Diamond Platnumz, apparently Hamisa is a witch. That's according to Diamond Platnumz. I was like, wait, what? So, until I clarify, I will confirm. But apparently, word goes out that an audio note was shared. And in that particular audio note, the voice behind the audio note may have been Hamisa Mobetto's. And it could have been recorded while she had gone to seek counsel with her voodoo king. Yes, her witch doctor. Now, apparently, in the voice note, if it was such a big deal, but anyway, it's my job to give the rumor and the gossip. So, in that voice note, she was talking to her witch doctor. She was saying, like, yeah, she knows Diamond likes her and all of that. He's been chasing her forever and she likes him too. But the problem is Diamond Platnumz's mom and all of that. Yidi yada. I was like, wait, what? In the 21st? In the 21st century? And then I kind of snapped back into reality that yes, in the 21st century, it's actually worse than it was before. Anywho, so I hear Diamond Platnumz comes out on Wasafi TV and he goes like, she's a witch, she's evil, she's the type of person. Apparently, they're broken up. I'm like, who cares? But clearly, there's a bunch of people that care because people WhatsApped me, inboxed me, called me trying to get the deets on the story. I'm like, well, wait. It's not like Hamisa didn't see this coming. That's what you get. That's what you get for being a bugaboo. Now, in my world, Hamisa was a bugaboo. I'm not going to say that the relationship between Diamond Platnumz and Hamisa is dead because, I mean, they have a baby. You know, that's the kind of issue that you never get away. You never walk away from once. You have a child with someone, it's a done deal, it's a wrap. They're forever going to be intertwined in your life. Now, the same thing goes for him and, you know, Zari. But Zari looks like she's out here living her best life, child, while Hamisa is left with picking up the pieces of what we call Diamond Platnumz's pride, ego. She's like trying to piece them together and make a formidable man out of it, but he has failed to. And then not forgetting she's also young and weird and she's Tanzanian. I love me some Tanzanians. Ooh, oh, I love Tanzanians. They are something else. And then Diamond Platnumz is the same. Manai. All in all, I'm saying we all knew this was a recipe for disaster. It was never going to happen or work, but hey, but and so no way to go. Now watch it where that you don't wait on Tanzania. Zebangambe Tanzania buli dogo jeriva. Ndiva Tanzania kati Diamond Platnumz geno no nyo na awe. Omusawo watu laba na singa. Just saying. Oh, well, they say love is blind. I'm starting to believe it, literally. It is blind, like, anyway, over the weekend, Dev Dash, our recovering drug addict, and I love to say that because every time I say that, I feel like it snaps him back into reality and he's like, I ain't moving next to that stuff again. So over the weekend, Dev Dash did walk down the aisle, yes, with another white girl. Why are we saying another? Because, well, he has a child and another. Clearly, that's his taste and he happens to be their taste. It's quite simple if you want to land a white girl in this country. Get you some dreadlocks. Don't have a particular J-O-B. Yeah, it doesn't have to be particular. You just have to be one of those, like, I do this, I do that, and let it be around the entertainment industry. You'll be laid real quick. But hey, cons to Dev Dash. He did walk down the aisle. He said the I do's. I don't know what happened between, oh yeah, we all know what happened between him and his first white chick. know, it's good to see him pick up the pieces, though. It's good, it's good. Because I thought he would relapse and go back to doing the drugs, but no. He's trying to keep a sober head on him. He opened up this Kataini company. The word keeps going around that it's doing well. I haven't witnessed how well it's doing, but I'm still proud because you never knock down a brother's hustle. So I'm proud, I'm glad. I don't know why everybody wanted to say something off about it. I'm like, you know what? Everybody needs somebody at the end of the day. Well, clearly not me, but he does. He clearly needs someone to put it all into perspective. And if this is the one that he has chosen, good for him. But again, love is blind. Kong's Dev Dash and the wife, we don't know where the honeymoon is and all of that. We don't know if he's coming back to Uganda. We don't know if he got married to secure the papers or if he love her or he don't love her. It's none of our business. All we know is she took his last name or he could have taken her last name. Which one could it be? Anyway, who cares? That happened. Remember how I told you how Desire Luzinda is going to quit music? This is her last album. She's transitioning into Obabi Chisabi Tegede. Man, when someone says the word transitioning, my mind flips. But she's out here. She's trying to promote the album and she's been doing all these nice things. She's much more mature according to her. I'm like, wait, girlfriend, how more mature can you get? You've been mature your entire life, boo-boo. But still, I think today's the day where I don't want to knock anybody's hustle. I honestly don't. Because we know how the story goes. Yes, she's praying at Finaro. It's a good thing she has found Christ. We all need to find her some Christ. But this is how the storyline plays out in the Ugandan music industry. She's going to get saved for like about 3 months. She'll do a video, or no, she'll do an entire album, do songs, and we'll keep on thinking she has transitioned into something. And then after 3 months, she'll be like, no, this ain't cutting it. I'm not securing the bag like I need to. But maybe she could be a different version, because Banenga binebi into Desire. For a long time, she has built houses, she has educated her daughter, she has lived a lavish lifestyle. I mean, it's a good thing when you notice, God, I set out to accomplish all these things I have, so I'm coming right back to you. Now, I'm hoping at some point, Zari will also see this. But hey, who am I to judge? Anyway, I was seeing a couple of the different things that she has on that album, and I'm sorry. No, I'm not really sorry. I was listening to it and I thought I would get something out of it and get shocked. But hey, it's still Desire. She still can't sing well, but she still has a lot of hustles to offer. If in case you fail to listen to the song, you can always just watch her. Yeah, there's nothing much coming out of there. Then I saw one video where she pulled off the same thing that Winnie Nwaji did for what song? Manyaka Kaimba, where Winnie Nwaji was seated on a boat. It's like after Beyonce did that entire floral photo shoot and everybody told everyone that florals are in, they're in, you know, they're the thing. They're all running wild with it. I'm just here to confirm to you, I hope that entire album has better than what I listened to on the low before she can even put it out there. Because what I listened to was dumb. It was very lackluster, very mediocre. It was all the things that come to mind when you say the name Desire Luzinda, minus the sex step. You definitely know that the world has opinions about you when someone... Someone as not so relevant as Rubber Dubber thinks that you are loose. Jesus is the Lord. Aye! Aye! So Rubber Dubber was asked recently between Lydia Jasmine, Spice Diana, and Sheba Karungi who he would want to try and do. If he were to, who would he go with, you know, to have a situationship with? And he was like, I'll go for the easy one. They're like, wait, what? Which easy one? And he just lets it drop. He's like, I'll go for 32. I was like, ash! Spice, your reputation is starting to precede you in the industry, boo-boo. Imagine Rubber Dubber had that to say about you. The last time Rubber Dubber had a hit was 10 years ago when he did Mr. DJ for the Swans thingy, that mashup, but he is here calling you loose. Jesus. Hey! Woo, child, you finna work on who you are. You've given yourself a very bad name. Good God, I'm not even going to delve into that. Like, let that simmer down. Woo! I mean, there are people who can call you loose and no kiddies. Who can call you loose and no kiddies? Personally, I mean, if Obama called you loose, then you'd know that definitely you're attracting over the right people. No, loose is loose, period. Loose is loose. Nah. To each his own. One man's meat is another man's poison. Like I said, it's a very, very, very... That's the word I was going to use in English. Chivudenau. Let's just say today is not my day, but I had to be here and give you all this gist. At TinaFierce1 is my Twitter handle, and on Facebook we are Scoop and Scoop at TinaFierce1. Like and follow the pages. On Instagram, it's at TinaFierce1 with an H. Yes, this episode was brought to you by Nana Herbal Mouthwash. Try the product, get the product. I'm out. Catch you again tomorrow when it's a Friday. Peace.
Scoop was sponsored by
Get Nana Herbal Mouthwash and your problems will be no more.